हेलो क्लास टेंथ, नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर बाय दिस ऑनलाइन क्लास। वी आर एंजॉयिंग आवर ऑफलाइन क्लास, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली अगेन वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। नाउ आई विल कंटिन्यू इटरेटिव कंस्ट्रक्ट इन जावा। दीज आर द लूप्स। First, there are two types of loop, exit control loop and entry control loop. First, I will explain you exit control loop. There are exit control loop are also do while loop. This is also known as the exit control loop. It is unfixed or unknown iterative loops. That is, user may not be aware how many times the iteration means how many times the loop will take place. As you know that I have explained the loop in class also. We are using for loop there. In when we are using for loop, that time we are writing for, then I is equal to 0, I less than n is equal to 5, 10, any numbers. These are the loops. So in do while loop, the condition is checked at the end of the loop. Suppose an example I am writing here, int p. P I have taken 1000 and r I have taken 10 and this is t year 4 year. This is a simple program. Suppose then I will take si in double. I am using do while loop, do then curly bracket. This is the simple interest formula and we will write the formula. Then we will write the P is equal to P plus SI. This is the amount. A is equal to P plus SI. Curly bracket while. This is do this condition. Then while. The condition is that P is less than and equal to 10,000. Because we have given 1,000 the value of P. But here we have written that the value of P is less than and equal to the 10,000. Now we are making a program which are related to the exit control loop. Suppose we are making a program, write a program to input a number, check and display whether it is a Nevine number or not. First, you know what is a Nevine number. A number is said to be Nevine if it is divisible by some of its digits. Means, suppose we have taken a number 128. If we will find the sum of its digit 1 plus 2 plus 8, then the result will be 9. 1 plus 2 plus 8 will be, 1 to 6, not 8, 1 to 6. The result of 1 to 6 will be 1 plus 2, 3, then plus 6 became 9. When we will divide this number by 9, now we will check this is divisible or not. Suppose we will divide 126 by 9, 9 ones are 9 and then 33 will come, 36, 9 fours are, means 14 is the quotient, means it is divisible by the 9, the sum of its digit. So first we will write the message to check Nevine number or not. 6 lines same, I told you. Import java.util, public class, we are writing the class name Nevine because this program related to the Nevine number. Then curly bracket, public static void main, string args. Curly bracket, scanner in is equal to new scanner system.in. This 6 line I have explained in class also. Now we will take int num. Num is the number which we will enter. The number which we will be checked that will be Nevine or not. This is the num, then d or then p, then sum. D divisible, finding the divisible. P it also used in the that number, and sum when we will find the sum of. So we don't know about the sum, so sum we will take 0. First we will enter the number, system.out println, enter a number. After entering the number, we will write the data type of that number. Num we have taken int, so that we will write NM, we have, now we have taken NM, not NUM. If you are taking int NM, NUM, then you will write NUM here. But by mistake, I have written NUM declaring the number. But when we are writing data type, that time I have taken NM. So just take care about this. By mistake, I have written like this. Now, NUM is equal to int dot next int. Then, now P is equal to num. Now, I will take, in place of num, I will take P. Because P and num both are the equal. Now, I will write the loop. Do curly bracket. Now, first we will divide the sum of that numbers. That is the D. D is D to find the remainder of that number. Suppose I will divide, D is equal to sum. Sum is 1 plus 2 plus 6 became 9. First we will divide that sum by the numbers. Then sum is equal to, by mistake I have written this sum. This is not sum. This is the number. I will divide that number. D is num divided by the 10. Then sum will become, sum is equal to sum and plus the D, which will come the remainder, which will come after dividing that number. Then sum 0 plus that divisible, that remainder will come, that will plus, the sum will come. Now num is equal to num divided by 10. This is the condition. First we will find the remainder. After that we will plus this that remainder with the sum of that number. Then we will find num. Then we will divide that number and we will find the quotient of that number. Then curly bracket close. Now we will write the condition. While num is not equal to 0, because if we will take any number which are equal to the 0, that number will not be divine. So the number will not equal to 0. Now we will write the condition. If that number p, which we have taken in place of num, if that p divided by the sum, that number, suppose the number is 126 and it divided by the 9 and the remainder will become 0. So that number, then we will print the system out println divine number. Otherwise it will print system out println not a divine number, because if the remainder will equal to 0, the number will be divine. Otherwise this number will not be divine number. Hope you all understood this question. If you have any problem, you can ask me about this question through mail. Now you will write the variable description of that number. First data type, name, data type and function. In name you will write, what you will write? Num, D, num, d, p, sum. These are the integer. Then num is equal to entering the number. Int, all data types will be int. Then function, num function, enter the number. D function, remainder of the number. P function, equal to the number. And sum, the sum of the digit of that number. This is the variable description of this program. Now, next is entry control loop. It checks the condition in the beginning. If the condition is true, the control is allowed to entry into the loop. Otherwise, it will stop that program there. There are entry control loop, for loop. For loop is used when number of iteration is fixed and known. Suppose we know that the iteration will be going through 10 times. So means we will use for loop. Otherwise we will use while loop. Yes, in here I have written for I is equal to 0 and I less than is equal to 10. It means the loop will be going through less than or equal to the 10 times. Then I plus plus. While loop, there are two entry control loop, for loop and while loop. This loop is used when user do not know the number of iteration, the number of loops. In while loop, the user cannot know how many times loop will be executed. While loop is unfixed or unknown iterative loop. In while loop, the condition is checked in the beginning of the loop. Suppose same way we have taken, which I have taken in exit control loop, then we will write while p is less than and equal to 10,000. Then we will write the formula, then we will write the formula of the both the numbers. Now, this is another question which are based on the entry control loop. Write a program to input a number, check and display whether it is a perfect number or not. A number is said to be perfect if sum the factors. This is by mistake I written neon. This is not a neon. This is a perfect number. If the sum of perfect including 1 and excluding the number itself, means including 1, 1 will be included, but that we will exclude that the number itself is the same as the original number. Suppose I have entered a number 6 and factors of 6 is 1, 2, 3. When we will find the factors of 6, it will be 1, 2 and 3. Because 1 multiplied 2 multiplied 3 became 6. And sum of this is 1 plus 2 plus 3 became 6. So, the sum of the factors is equal to the original number. That is known as the perfect number. To check, first we will write the message to check perfect number. Then we will, 6 lines are same, which I told you. Import java.util, public class, perfect number we are using. Class name here, curly bracket, public static void main, string args, then curly bracket. Now, next line, scanner in is equal to new scanner system.in. Now, we will write what is the int data type. Int, first we will take number which we will enter, int n, then comma, we will take l also. And S for sum is equal to sum we have taken. First we will enter the number, enter a number. Then we will write the data type of that number, n is equal to in dot next int. Now we will write the loop for I is equal to 0 because we know and I is less than and equal to n. Suppose the number is 6, so that loop will be going 6 times here. Suppose I have written input number 10, the loop will be going to 10 times because this is the fixed loop, fixed entry control loop. So, we will write I is less than and equal to n. It is based on the number which we have entered in the program. Then I plus plus, then curly bracket. Now, first if we will divide that number n divided by I equal to 0, then s is equal to s plus I, then s plus I, this is I, then s plus I, then curly bracket will be closed. Now you will write the condition, if sum equal enter number, both are the equal, then system out println perfect number, otherwise system out println not a perfect number. Means the if the sum and the original number both are the same, then perfect number, otherwise it is not a perfect number. Now you will write the variable description of that number. Variable description. In variable you will write NIS. N for all the three number data is int data type. Now function. N enter the number. I loop. And S sum of the digits. The sum of the factors. Understood? This is the questions. Hope you all understood these questions. Student, you will write these questions in your computer notebook also, and I will give some more questions to do that and you will try that questions. If you will have any type of problem, you can ask me through mail, but you will see the complete video. If you will not see the complete video, you cannot understand any program and you will not do any program. So, it is my advice to you that you will see all the subjects video, not my subject. You will see all the subjects video. After that, you will try to do the assignment. Hope you will complete that assignment if you will see complete video. Thank you.